This year we made the difficult decision to travel.
We're going from Nashville to the Olympic Peninsula in Washington State. Mm-hmm. Over the next few weeks, we're talking about how to travel during a pandemic, how to pack for a family of six using only carry-on suitcases, how to catch and cook the fresh crabs we're gonna catch. If that sounds good to you, come back every Wednesday, hit the subscribe button below.
And give us one of those thumbs ups.
I'm Nina. This is Frazier. We're two people that met, fell in love, and decided adventuring was our favorite thing to do. Along the way, we added four kids to the squad. Anaya, Rain, Zahira, and Kiona. Subscribe and join us as we explore our home planet together.
We know that this is a contentious issue and many people are trying to weigh the pros and cons of what they feel like is best for them. But as of now, airlines are still flying. We're gonna list for you guys the factors that we went through in coming to this decision. This is in no way a recommendation on what you should do. I think everybody should follow CDC guidelines. We are working within that framework. So we're gonna walk you guys through the process of how we came to the decision to travel. So here we go.
So the first thing that we had to decide when weighing the pros and cons of all of this is, were we gonna fly or drive? We're going from Nashville to the Olympic Peninsula in Washington State. It's a long drive. Given the fact that it's winter, it's not the best idea to be driving that far.
There's a couple things that we came to in terms of deciding to fly.
First thing, we have to reduce exposure. How are we going to do that? We are going to quarantine 3 days before we get our COVID tests, and then continue with that same strict quarantine until the time of our departure.
We decided to go with Alaskan Airlines. They are a subsidiary airline of Delta. Both airline companies, if you look at their website, have very clear communication on how they are reducing exposure during a pandemic.
They make everybody wear masks. They have strict sanitation protocol.
The middle seats on all flights are blocked except for families through January 2021. Their air filters are HIPAA upgraded, so it's the cleanest air you could possibly get once you're on the airplane.
We decided for me to go earlier with the kids and fly in the middle of the week, first flight out of the day.
Trying to miss those holiday crowds. I had to stay back so I could work a few more days, and then I'm actually leaving out on Saturday morning at the first flight out.
Another thing we considered when thinking about risk exposure in airports were the amount of time that we were in the facilities.
So we decided to pay a little bit more and have a direct flight so that we didn't have to have stop time in between cities and different airports.
Because of that, we are choosing to fly only carry-on luggage.
So what do you need to do to travel safely this holiday season? Number one, make sure you quarantine and get tested before you ever go to the airport. Number two, book a direct flight if possible. Fly at a time where there's not going to be many people. PreCheck will help you skip security lines. Pack your stuff and carry on luggage. And lastly, make sure to social distance. Be safe, everyone. See you out there.
Come back next week to see how we pack for a family of six only using carry-on baggage.
So because we're traveling around the holidays,
the camera, baby. Our local airport, Nashville International, BNA, BNA, that is not sign language. I don't know what I'm doing. They have recently gone through a massive renovation, making their terminal sizes much bigger.